like all hope is gone. Give it to Jesus. Oh yeah. He is the answer to every one of your problems. Why don't you try Jesus?
Hello, my friends. Hello, my sisters and brothers. I come to greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Certainly, we are living in difficult times, times that we've never seen nor experienced before, things that don't seem like they'll ever be the same. But I want to encourage you today. I want you to know that God is yet in control. He controls all things. He controls the world. So if he allows it, then there must be a way out of every pandemic, everything that's happening that we're facing even now. These things have been spoken in prophecies by the old prophets. in the Old Testament, Daniel and Isaiah and Jeremiah, all of them spoke of this time that we're now living in. And it's so amazing how God would give the wisdom and the insight, the foresight into the things that we are now experiencing today in this land. But yet and still, I want you to know, don't panic, don't get discombobulated, because God is yet in control. He's yet in control. He sent us his son, Jesus, to save a lost and dying world. And because he sent his son, he died for the remission of all of our sins. He died for everything that's going on even right now. And I'll prove that to you. I just want to encourage you. Now let's go to the Word of God. I want to take you briefly, if you don't mind. I want to take you into the Gospel of John, the 16th chapter, and the 32nd and 33rd verse. Jesus was speaking to his disciple on the night, or should I say the evening, before his crucifixion. And he was telling them, warning them about the things that will come ahead. And but in doing so, he also encouraged them, don't become distraught. Don't be discombobulated behind all the things that's going on, because I will send you a comforter. And that's what he did. But in verses 32 and 33, he says, "Behold, the hour cometh, yea, is now come, that ye shall be scattered, every man to his own, and shall leave me alone. And yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me." That's Jesus speaking of his own crucifixion that's about to come to pass. Verse 33 says, "These things have I spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace." Put an asterisk by that word peace. In him, in Jesus, that we might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation. And I think now we should pay special attention, because we're now having tribulation. The Bible has already spoken of these things, but our peace rests in Jesus. Look at somebody, if you can, in the house with you, just tell them, "My peace rests in Jesus, for he is my peace." But he says that these things I have spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye should have tribulation, but be of good cheer. That he is admonishing his disciples, I want you to be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. Now this is Jesus' farewell speech. This is his final speech to his disciple before his crucifixion. And he speaks concerning the work, the power of the Holy Spirit, that the joy of the believers, his victory over the world. And he says, and he tells them, that your hope must remain in God. Now, that let's take a look at that, and let's hear my voice. Your hope, everything that you are, your being, your well-being, your peace of mind, it must remain in God, because he created us. He created this earth. He created everything that we are, the well-being, the well-association, the well parts of our mind, the way we think, the way we move about. We must be in peace. We must be assured that God is our refuge, that he is our peace. And if we cannot go to anybody else, we can go to him. Can I get a witness up out there? We can go to him, because he has sent his son, Jesus, and he is our Savior. He came to redeem all mankind, and he suffered a great penalty. And so what I am saying to you, that our hope, we must remain, our hope is in God, for God is our peace. And then he tells them, Jesus tells them, "For I have overcome the world." I have overcome the world. Jesus came to die. I might as well tell you that right now. He didn't come to stay and to live among us. He came to die, for he was Jesus. He was God's only son. He sent him to the world to redeem the world. He sent him to redeem the lost. So he sent his only begotten son. He so loved us so that he gave us his only begotten son, and he sent him to die. So the weight of the world was upon his shoulder. He was pierced for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The punishment that brought peace was on him. And Jesus, and because of his suffering wounds, we are healed. What do you mean, preacher, that we are healed? We're healed. We're healed from the things that may ail us. We're healed from the sufferings of this world. We are healed from things that binds us. We're healed from things that are so distractible. We're healed from things that comes. If I may say, we're healed from things that comes to steal, kill, and destroy us. For we have a Redeemer. And because of the suffering of Christ Jesus, we all have been redeemed. I come by to tell you today, be of good cheer. Don't worry about the things that's going on, because God got everything in control. For the earth is the Lord, the fullness thereof, the world, and he that dwell therein, it all belongs to him. Hallelujah. And because we are believers, we have an advocate. That advocate is Jesus. But more importantly, we have a way to God. And in my finishing, I want to tell every one of us to be of good courage, be of good cheer. We cannot afford to give up right now. Believers, I don't care how hard it gets or what it seems like. We have been ordained to go into the world, into the highways and the hedges, and compel men to come to God. Yes, many of the churches have been closed. Yes, it doesn't seem like we can come together as a congregant and fellowship. As the Bible says, forsake not the assembling among ourselves. Yes, it seemed that way, but it is enough in every one of us to go and tell up the gospel. What is the gospel? It is the good news of Christ Jesus, that he came to redeem the whole world. So we must, while we have this chance, while we're yet living, we have the opportunity to go out into the highways and the hedges and compel men to come to Christ. For the world is coming to the end. I believe Jesus is on his way back. But before he gets back, he has given us this opportunity. So I said to every one of us, we must commission ourselves. We must be deputized. We must go out into the worlds. It doesn't matter what they look like or what they smell like or how they appear to be. We must approach them and tell them the good news about Jesus, our Savior. Finally, my brethren, in all that you do, you rest your peace in God and not man. Man cannot give you peace. Only God can give you the peace. For the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, may that peace gird your minds and your hearts. Through Christ Jesus I speak. Amen.